Hey Star Wars Rebels fans, my name's Joel Robinson, and recently I got to see Star Wars Rebels Episode 8, Gathering Forces, and I wanted to share what I saw with you. Last week's episode, Empire Day, followed Ezra and the crew of the Ghost as they tracked down a Rodian named Zeebo, who was a servant to the Bridger family. Ezra and the crew helped Zeebo escape the Empire after realizing he has been implanted with the blueprints to a huge number of Imperial vehicles and plans. Not only that, but Zeebo has been able to access the record of what happened to Ezra's parents, for which Ezra becomes very bitter and defensive about.
Coward! You could have stopped them! Why didn't you stop them?
The episode starts off as a direct continuation of last week, with the crew of the Ghost trying to escape the Inquisitor. This leads to some great action and dogfights between the crew of the Ghost and the TIE pilots. The Ghost does escape, but it is tagged by the Inquisitor with a tracking device, similar to what we see in Episode 2 with Obi-Wan and Jango Fett. Kanan is worried because the Inquisitor can sense he and Ezra's Force presence, similar to what we see in Empire Strikes Back with Luke and Darth Vader. Kanan decides that the only way to protect Zeebo and the secrets he holds is for Ezra and he to detach the Phantom, the smaller ship that's part of the larger Ghost, while in hyperspace, and lead the Inquisitor away from the main ship. The falling out of hyperspace looked awesome, but it did remind me of 2001 Space Odyssey with the Stargate. Hera decides to take Zeebo to Fulcrum, who can utilize his secrets to help the not-yet-formed rebellion. I was very excited to see that Fulcrum is going to be in this episode again, not only because of my theories about who this character is, but because of the dynamic it creates on the show. In case you guys want to know about my theories about Fulcrum and who the character really is, and whether it might be a character from the Clone Wars, I will include a link and annotation at the end of this video. Anyways, back to this episode. So Ezra is confronted with the necessity to forgive Zeebo for not saving his parents, in order to be able to connect with the Phicrons, the creatures Hera and Sabine encountered in the abandoned clone base. This was an excellent development for Ezra, and a major opportunity for the growth of his character. It was a super intense moment, one of the most exciting of the entire season. It definitely gave me a feeling that they were alluding to Daniel and the Lion's Den, the biblical story. I'm not sure this is what they're going for, but it definitely had that same feel. Tell me down in the comments whether you see any other allusions Star Wars Rebels is making to any other literature or movies. So once Ezra forgives Zeebo, he creates this kind of weird forced telepathy where Zeebo can hear Ezra's thoughts. This was the only weird part. I guess it is possible in the Star Wars universe. We did see this kind of telepathy in The Empire Strikes Back, where Darth Vader talks, or rather thinks, at Luke. So I don't feel like they're going too far off canon, but still, just something about it didn't quite feel as natural. So as Ezra and Kanan are hanging out in this cave, the Inquisitor tracks them down. And this epic lightsaber battle occurs, and the Inquisitor proves his skill. He makes Kanan look like a Padawan, quickly defeating him and literally throwing him in the corner. Then Ezra grabs Kanan's lightsaber and defends his master, just like Darth Vader defending Luke in Return of the Jedi. The Inquisitor thrusts the lightsaber from Ezra's hand and then thrusts him to the edge of this crevasse. This is where everything goes super crazy. Ezra has like this Force Hulk out moment, where he controls the mind of this giant Phrynok monster and sends it to attack the Inquisitor. Kanan comes back to consciousness, grabs Ezra, and runs. They escape back to the Phantom and make it off the planet, inexplicably past the Star Destroyer. They reconnect with the Ghost, and Sabine gives Ezra a birthday gift, a picture with he and his parents. Overall, I give this episode a 9 out of 10. It was the best episode of this season, and definitely gives me a lot of hope for what they can do with longer story arcs. But tell me what you think. Do you think that Star Wars Rebels should start pursuing longer story arcs, or do you like it when they're short and concise? Tell me down in the comments. And if you'd like to see my latest episode of theory crafting about who Fulcrum is, then you can click the annotation right here, or the link down in the description. Beyond that, thank you for watching, and subscribe.